Buenas tardes. I'm here in Mexico City at Automotive Logistics Mexico 2020 with Dr. Karl Friedrich Koch, who's the Director of Logistics for BMW Mexico in the brand new plant in San Luis Potosí. So, Dr. Koch, I wanted to start talking about this year because it's a ramp-up year. Production is going, I think, to 75,000, as we talked about earlier, and we're going from exporting to or delivering to 3 markets to 30 markets. So can you talk to us a little about what you're doing to build up this network and start to reach 30 markets as an exporter?
Okay, thanks, Chris. Yes, we're ramping up second shift. That means doubling capacity and utilizing it with regard to the markets, 30 markets worldwide. For us, the principle remains the same, with the majority going via Veracruz or Lázaro Cárdenas. In addition, we ramp up this year a railroad track to central USA and Canada. And then, outside of the ports, we utilize the global distribution network of BMW. So that is not affecting so much the plant at itself.
I see. So obviously this, with these new rail routes to the U.S., obviously rail to between U.S. and Mexico has been a big theme, as you know, for many OEMs here. Are you anticipating a smooth launch, or are you working ahead of anything to kind of prepare to make sure that happens?
Yes, we expect a smooth ramp up. And overall, we are also easy because we have the alternative version of truck transportation. What is more, plant internal issue is with integrating right-hand drive, PHEV, and so on. We get a lot more of parts, and the complexity we have increases we have to handle.
So on the mode of complexity, you mentioned in the presentation that there's new models coming, obviously, a brand new model, I believe, in 21 or 22?
21 and 22.
And 22 brand new models. So that's already a difference to producing an existing model there. So that brings, what are some of the challenges you're anticipating in bringing a brand new model to Mexico in the same time as expanding a ramp up? I can imagine it's going to bring a lot more part complexity.
Yes, and it's a new challenge. For the existing 3 series, we were 6 months behind the lead plant in Munich. So on principle, we got a mature product in our brand new plant. Now the new models coming up will be world models, just and only produced in Mexico. And that means we will have more issues in the early phase coming from engineering we have to solve. So that's really a new challenge for us.
And you already mentioned, even with the 3 series bringing right-hand drive and bringing, will we also be looking at potential variations of powertrain and different complexities there?
Yes, we will get everything. For the 30 markets, we will get diesel engine, additional gasoline engines, we will get M derivatives, we get the hybrids, so a lot of more complexity.
So that in and of itself will demand supply chain resilience and flexibility, I imagine. Yeah.
Yes. But on the other hand side, we already planned our supply chain for that complexity. It's filling up the plant capacity.
Okay. So one of the things you also mentioned on stage I wanted to fill up was some of the technology you brought to Mexico from a supply chain point of view. There's different automation in the plant. And you also talked about a connected supply chain, more visibility, integrated also into SAP, into the production. Can you talk a little bit more about how that's working and what benefits it's bringing?
Yes, we recognize at an early phase for that new plant that the long inbound supply chain is a challenge for us, BMW, with our build-to-order process. So we definitely demand stability in our supply chain. And transparency is the base for stability, because then you can react. So also, we wanted to go to the leading edge of digitalization. So our idea was to have really full transparency about which part is in which box, in which container, in which truck or airplane, at which location of the time. And not just the transparency of that, but also have the interaction with our internal SAP system. How much of these parts do we have on stock? So and so, how long are we able to produce with this part number without a problem? And that's just not as transparency or information in huge data lakes, also with automated information to the material controllers, 99.9% is going well, don't care about it, but take care about these 0.1% of the parts.
That is the critical bit, isn't it? And I can imagine that this transparency is particularly important when you have disruptions like coronavirus coming down the pipe.
That comes on top, yes. This is maybe now a very special case. There we, in these incidents, we recognize that we have good transparency about our first tier suppliers and what's going on. The challenge now with the coronavirus is more coming to the second and third tier suppliers. So we may get parts from Conti, but do we have the full transparency about their second, third tier suppliers they getting parts from? And that is, for that case, now the major issues.
Well, that's a challenge that is not unique to BMW, so we certainly know that everyone is facing that. Dr. Koch, thank you so much for your time.
Best of luck
with the ramp up. We're going to be talking more about it, I'm sure.
Thank you very
much. Thanks a lot. Cheers. Great.
You can leave the doctor out.
There's your coffee.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much. Yeah, that's great.